Hi, my name is Kentama, a VTuber, and your little PogChamp. Or at least I used to be. You see, normally I stream 3 days a week on Twitch, week after week, trying to be the best little brother VTuber I can be.
Wait till she hears me say c***.
But at the moment, I'm struggling with probably one of the biggest things that content creators dread. Burnout. And it sucks. A lot. Nothing you do feels good enough. And as a result, you don't want to do anything. And then by not doing anything, your motivation goes down the drain. Then the cycle continues, so on and so forth. What hurts the most is that my brain has been searching and longing for the excitement of making things that I had just a couple of months ago. A couple of months ago! It literally feels like yesterday! Specifically, it got me nostalgic for my debut back in December.
I also don't like the Olive Garden. That place can actually go suck a dick, though.
Things were different then. There was road to be paved and things to learn and experience. For as scary as it was, it felt very fresh and new. And I think that's why I love and value that time so much in my memory. When I look back at my debut stream and my corny attempt at lore, what I said back then still stands now.
I want to be happy. I want to feel satisfied with the things that I am making now and how I am going about them. I want to feel content.
Content. I have to be happy with the stuff that I am making. And at the moment, I'm not. But I've never been one to give up on what's important, at least not without trying. And I genuinely love being Tama. I love doing this and I love talking to you guys. I just need to find that spark again that makes it special. So I want to try something new and I want to try something fresh, something that plays to my strengths and frankly is way more my speed. Like this. Hi, I'm Ken. Dad? I should probably explain a little bit. First of all, I'm on camera, so that's a little different. For those of you that only know me as a VTuber, this might seem a little weird, but there are a whole other group of people that have seen me be on a certain technology YouTube channel as part of my day job. But lately, I've been wanting to make my own YouTube thing, or at least again. You see, I've been making YouTube videos, all different kinds, for the past 12 years. I started making tech content in my bedroom when I was in high school, and then I got into anime and made videos about anime figures when I was still collecting them. That was in college. When I graduated, I stopped making content for myself and started working on the Austin Evans YouTube channel. Though it's not like I totally stopped making videos for myself. I actually made a mini vlog series. By mini, I mean short-lived. I made a short-lived vlog series, which was called... Man, what was that thing called? I think it was called, like, Dear Channel. I would start the videos with, Dear Channel, today, blah, 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 blah. Stupid name. But that was the last time that I made YouTube videos for myself. And that was 4 years ago. And I know that because that was the first time that I went to Japan and I vlogged it. Now, obviously, at this point, I was hella weeb already. And so being in Japan was kind of nuts. I did what any weeb in Japan would do. Explore all the anime things. I explored Akihabara and bought a lot of stuff. But one of my favorite things that I did in that vlog was just straight up visit real life spots in anime. Or tried to visit anime spots in real life. I got to go to Shinjuku Gyoen, which is still one of my favorite spots in Tokyo, but most importantly, it is where the Makoto Shinkai movie Garden of Words takes place. And you can actually see in that video, there are some side-by-side shots that really look like they're in the anime. Now, the reason why I didn't keep up with that vlog was because I didn't feel like I was properly equipped to do it. I was at the time very slow at video editing. I was very worried about building my vlogging style, which of course wouldn't even really be a thing if I didn't see it through to begin with. That was a demotivating factor. And probably the most important thing, as someone that's super self-conscious and as someone that also has to edit himself for the video, I was just very awkward on camera.
How to deal?
Now, all of this on top of the fact that I still have my day job to think about, I wouldn't have the mental bandwidth to do two content creation things at once, which the rest is history. I just stopped making the vlog. Fast forward to 2020 with the you know what taking over the world. I did what a lot of people did to make the most out of the situation, and I started my Twitch channel. Now, whenever I reflect back on me starting Twitch streaming, I always think about it as one of the best decisions that I have ever made in my entire life. Now, for context, I've been working for my boss, Austin Evans, for the past 5 years as a production lead. It is a cool job that also has a lot of perks, and I definitely don't like taking it for granted. You know, you work the same content creator job day in and day out. For as special as it is, I also need to figure out ways to just be more creatively fulfilled. And I found that in my Twitch stream. I streamed and streamed and streamed. I did this for months. I was having the time of my life. I was getting to talk about all kinds of things, and I was building an audience of my own, a community. The streams helped me be better on camera for my day job. It was great. And then I debuted as a VTuber, as Kentama. And I'll say that if Twitch streaming was one of the best decisions that I made in my entire life, then Kentama is that tenfold.
It's me, your vlogging little PogChamp, Kentama!
I was able to actually be more personable, which gave me the confidence to build not only the best content that I could make for the audience watching me, but also to fulfill myself as an artist and as a content creator. Which brings me now to the current situation that I'm in, the burnout. It took a lot of reflecting and a lot of thinking, but I think it is time to just go back to basics. Simply, I'm just going back to my roots, making YouTube videos about the things that I am passionate about and love talking about the most. Now, if you don't know me, I used to joke on my Twitter that I have 5 too many hobbies. But these are things that genuinely interest me. Things like technology and anime. And I also love to travel. Not that I can really do much of that. At some point in the future, I'll probably be able to make some travel vlogs or something. And if you've seen the Kentama streams or have seen clips on Twitter or can even piece together based on what I'm doing in this video, I like reflecting on life stuff as a full-time professional content creator, talking about personal experiences and insight for anyone that's curious about what goes on in here. Head empty. And don't worry, you're little PogChamp ain't going nowhere. Y'all still gotta deal with me too. Twitch.tv/Kentama_CH. This video, the one that you guys are watching right now, is episode 0, the beta of a series that I like to call Tamalog. If you guys are curious about where this channel is gonna go, please consider hitting that subscribe button and show me some thumbs if you guys like the video. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-nee! Cringe as fuck.